How worried are you about U.S. diplomats right now throughout North Africa and the Middle East? You were endangered when you were in Iraq, as all of us remember, starting back in 2003.
Yeah, well, let me say, first of all, I send my condolences to my colleagues who served and died in Libya. And Americans tend to forget that they're American diplomats putting their lives on the line all over the world every day. I think we should be concerned because what we are seeing now is the spread that started in two countries. Today it moved to three or four more, including Iraq, which is quite a ways from North Africa. And that spread is eerily reminiscent of what we all went through in the late 1970s.
In Iran?
Not just in Iran. We had an ambassador killed in Kabul, followed by the embassy in Islamabad being burned to the ground, followed by the takeover in Tehran. I mean, these kinds of things have a way of spreading, and I think they are a mark of the fact that the administration has basically conveyed weakness in this region, and weakness always begets trouble.
So what should the administration, in your opinion, be doing?
What it should be doing is what they're starting to do now. It took them a while to find their voice. I mean, the president, in his first Rose Garden speech, said nothing about the attack in Egypt. There seems to still be confusion in the administration as to what exactly our relationship with Egypt is. But the key problem is that the people who are opposed to us are Islamic extremists. The administration seems to be having trouble finding its voice, recognizing this reality.